They're Britain's Spice Girls, the pop group that started with a small ad in the paper and developed into a multi-million dollar industry. Critics have questioned their musical ability, but that hasn't even dented their growing worldwide fame. Mark Burrows looks at the Spice Girl phenomenon.
Hi, we're Spice Girls!
Girl power and the Spice Girls know no bounds. The band's influence stretches around the globe, having reached number one in 27 countries.
I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. No, tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I wanna really, really want.
They have sold 13 million albums and 14 million singles, figures that put them in a league they could have never imagined, according to record producer Pete Waterman.
This is Michael Jackson territory. That's what these girls have done. They've entered Michael Jackson territory. You know, they are now way, way, way above pop status.
Waterman speaks with some authority. As a member of the producing trio of Stock, Aitken and Waterman, he helped manufacture the music careers of Kylie Minogue and Jason Donovan. Spice Girls are the manufactured female equivalent of British boy band Take That. But unlike Take That, the Spice Girls have succeeded in cracking America. And when it comes to marketing, they have easily eclipsed every packaged band before them. They now star in their own Pepsi ad. The next single and first live concert will be marketed by Pepsi. While the Spice Girls have evolved into a sophisticated industry, they had a humble start, getting together by answering a newspaper ad placed by accountant Bob Herbert.
We found a gap in the market and we looked for four or five girls who could fill that gap.
The Spice Girls spent all of a year polishing their act before they were unleashed on the airwaves.
They were manufactured not to be manufactured. They were actually allowed to be themselves.
Thanks to new management, in just 2.5 years, the Spice Girls shot from obscurity to fame, and this encounter with a flustered Prince Charles. The music is just one way the Spice machine is keeping the fans happy.
Yeah, I need that one.
Fair chance this week's pocket money is being spent on the latest Spice Girls swap cards. And at a factory near Coventry, Spice Girls Limited operates a mail order business, selling everything from jackets to mugs and t-shirts.
If you netted it all in with merchandising, with TV rights, videos, record sales, public performances, endorsements, television commercials, easy, 120 to 150 million.
That's $300 million, a staggering sum considering they have still only released one album.
They've actually done a superb job, really, stretching the Spice Girls, I'd say rather limited appeal, to the most enormous, huge money spinner for everybody.
Skeptics may doubt their talent and their singing ability, but already the Spice Girls have earned $40 million in royalties alone. They're shaping up as Britain's most successful pop export since the Beatles. And in the footsteps of the lads from Liverpool and A Hard Day's Night, the next big project, Spice the Movie, launched to a rapturous reception at the Cannes Film Festival, despite the fact it hasn't been made.
All that I want from you is a promise you will be there. They will be there.
Oblivion may be looming, but the Spice Girls are proving masters at cashing in while on top. In London, Mark Burrows for Nightline.